Oh, we got another incoming.
Greetings.
Hello, Breton. Long time no see.
Yeah.
We have the Netherlands here.
Yes, this is the Netherlands. I'm not sure if the streamers have noticed, but we have just a year ago or so proclaimed the Make Hanover Fat Pact with...
No, mm-hmm. Prussia was just telling us.
Ah, excellent. They have also... they were on the stream just now?
Yes.
Ah, damn. Totally missed that.
Yep.
But anyway, the Dutch would like to offer their unconditional support to the Hanoverians for everything they have done to help Dutch interests, while claiming very little for themselves. We do try to support the weaker nations economically.
Wait. Let's roll that back a second. You just said you want to support the weaker nations economically while giving 200 ducats a month to Prussia.
Well, but that's an ally. That's different.
Russia. And Russia. Or did you just, like, mistake it for, like, you know, Russia, it's the same country?
No, so Russia is actually, because they're a signatory of the Dutch World Bank.
Oh.
So they are sending us their trade value, and
we have blue flames. I think the war has started.
Okay,
so,
yeah,
I'm sorry. Thank you. Yeah, thank you for dropping by, brother. It was great hearing you again. I haven't heard you for almost a year now.
Yeah, damn Corona, man. But it was nice to hear you.
Yep. All right, thanks.
Yeah, there we go.
Okay, it's popping off. Who's in this? Prussia, Switzerland, Russia. Russia is in.
Yeah. Oh, is
on
Russia
the Swiss side?
On
yes!
the Swiss side. Holy shit!
That's what I was hoping for.
I didn't expect that.
So although their troops are not prepared.
Yeah, their troops are not moving either.
They're
like.
Not ready.
But this makes it sort of like a weird Schlieffen plan, right? France, Switzerland, something like that.
I don't know if going straight through the defensive line counts as a Schlieffen plan.
Yeah. But I do feel like
it's like a reverse Schlieff.
Yeah. But it does feel like here Prussia is probably still going to win because they're just going to hit through the fortresses of Switzerland without a problem. Let's see, actually, Age of Absolutism. Yeah, they have 100 Absolutism.
Prussia's, just to put this in perspective, Prussia's entire income is basically the Dutch money.
Yeah.
Hang on, there's a pack that I'm going to take a look at real quick here.
Oh. There we go.
Oh, so many packs. Milan signs a pack with Prussia. It consists on a mutual cooperation agreement. Prussia will let Milan invade the Pope. Milan will let Prussia invade Switzerland.
Oh, wow.
So Milan is going to turn on the Pope, which, again, lovely. So it's basically a tit-for-tat agreement. You can hit Switzerland, and I will hit the Pope.
Oh, but the Swiss are putting a lot of damage on them, though. In the morale, not in casualties because of the discipline. But
yeah. The Hanoverian.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I can't word mouth anymore apparently today. And they just got wrecked.
Yeah, so let's see here. All right, so since Switzerland has a million people to kill off, and they have the Swiss Guard, they...
How many people died in that, in those two battles? Check real quick, because it's just been those two battles.
Yeah.
How many people died in that?
4 to 1,000 on their side, and 6 to 1,000 on Prussia-Hanover.
Well, it was about the same, and then they have 20,000 from attrition. So, about equal combat casualties.
So,
but 100,000 dead in the first few days. Maybe we are going to get a better fight than I expect.
Yeah. I mean, and if we look, they've done it. They've done the defensive and then manpower and everything. Prussia has not done that, having a little bit of hubris and thinking we're Prussia.
Yeah, definitely.
Right now, Switzerland is probably also like clocking in
Hanover.
More manpower a month. Yeah,
always
a thousand
dual
more.
Dual battles, I love it.
Switzerland's gonna win that one, and then they're immediately gonna turn to this one and win that one as well.
The Swiss have two more stacks.
Yep, I think Switzerland is probably gonna win both of these battles.
But there's just so many more troops coming in, though.
Yeah, though, the Prussians has a lot more troops.
70k with a 3-star general flanking.
No.
Hello, fellow hosts.
Hello.
Hello, Josh.
Hello.
It's that time again.
We are going to leave you at the start of another bloodbath, thankfully.
Yes, I can see.
And the Russians are still doing nothing.
The cowardly Russians.
So is this still the same war, or is it a new war? This is a new war.
Okay. It was a gentleman's agreement, it feels like.
Right.
The Prussians were doing like, huh, we're so big and strong, we're giving you time to prepare for a war against us. And and the Swiss got the Russians to join in on the war, but the Russians are not doing anything.
Oh, I see. Okay.
That's Russians are technically in on the war, but aren't actually fighting. Their troops have not moved an inch.
No.
Oh, right. Because I was following along, and I was getting almost concerned that the same papal war they started when we were on stream last would still be going when I took over. But thankfully, they seem to have been able to resolve it.
With about 10 provinces changing hands, all said and done, for 7.5 million cash.
Bargain price. I see. France is no longer France. They're now Switzerland again.
Yep, they're Switzerland, and they actually haven't recruited the Swiss army, which would be very handy for them to have in this war. They have the Free Swiss Guard and I think the Swiss Home Guard. So they have two armies of 60k. Well, one is 32k that they can recruit.
They don't have an economy, though.
Mm.
Well, they have the money to recruit it and then just take all the loans they have, because this is going to be a hell of a fight. They're fighting alone against two nations, both being funded by the Dutch.
Wow. Okay, that's a pretty, pretty hefty block. Well, I will allow you to relieve yourselves and say goodbyes, and I will see you all chat very shortly.
All right.
I think it's our time, Grugi.
Yeah.
We are going to leave you with Josh and Count Christo again, Michael. They will continue to the end of this, and we would like to bid you all adieu and enjoy the bloodbath.
Hello, everybody.
Hello there, stream. It's I, Josh, and I'm joined once again by Michael, and we're here observing more madness in Europe.
So I believe there was just a Ming intervention, I'm being told. Oh my lord!
Come on, Ming.
That's gonna that's definitely gonna shake things up. Let's reacquaint ourselves with the current state of play. We obviously have a Prussian war here, the Hanoverian conquest of Würzburg.
Yes.
Würzburg, I think. And they've gone for it. Wow, look at that morale advantage for the Swiss.
That's huge.
But yes, Ming joining in on the Hanoverian side. Yeah, instantly kicked out. Look at the absolute size of the Prussian armies. We were talking earlier about the level of development being done in Italy. Some must have been done in Prussia since then. But we will see. Apart from that, obviously, since we were last here, major developments, the death of Karaman, players moving over to Andalusia. I'm glad Andalusia is still going to have players. It would be sad
I missed that. What happened to Karaman?
So Karaman essentially got destroyed, and basically the players somewhat accepted their fate, and we needed players in Andalusia anyway.
Over there.
So Russia is going to have to focus on Ming, one would think, right? And they have got sizable forces over here. Pretty much all of Russia's forces. Actually, no, jeebus. Look at the number of troops Russia has. Wow, they're preparing a defensive line, it seems. But most of them over there in dealing with Ming. Oh, look at this opportunistic attack.
Scary Swiss stacks.
They generally are. Well,
3-fire advantage there against...
are they going to get the stack wipe before the reinforcements arrive?
Hanover's flag. I thought it was some kind of like step nation then, but it's not. It's Hanover.
Do you know the flag of Hanover? Come on.
Well, I don't often see them in form, really.
No, it's fair enough. All right, so we've got another. This Swiss attack looks bold to me. Prussia not reinforcing it yet. They feel like they don't need to, but we will see. We will see. I have to. Oh, that is. Look at the morale advantage is just doing so much damage. But wow, the Prussians. With a 0.5 tactics advantage, that's gotta hurt. That's really gotta hurt.
It is good though, seeing a nation that can stand up to the Prussian modifiers.
Solo stand up to Prussian modifiers. Yeah. Not even with no Milan aid this time. Milan without any formal allies right now, not a great place to be. And the Papal State clearly some kind of relationship breakdown going on between them and Switzerland in the last time. Of course, we may have missed something. Do the Swiss have the 20% morale event or something? It's a very good question. Let's look at what's causing this this monster morale for the Swiss. No, it's just Golden Era is helping. 22%
from army tradition.
Yeah, Golden Era is helping out as one of the defined things. They've also got the Reform Citizenry, which is really nice. Look at this Swiss panic button getting hit.
And of course, their French ideas, which they've kept, even though they are now Switzerland again.
I do love that they have returned from the from France to Switzerland. That's a great thing to see. Do we have any other? No, this is the only player war right now. Good. So we will. Don't worry, chat. We will keep our focus razor sharp on the current state of affairs here. That the problem with Switzerland, they got tons of morale. Ugh, morale doesn't save you from losses. Look at this. Even numbers so far on the losses, but remember, a lot of the losses on the Prussian side are gonna be coming from Ming. Oh no, actually, almost none of them. That's interesting. Okay, manpower wise, Switzerland has quite a bit more. Interesting to see Switzerland falling back in several directions here. I guess they were forced to retreat, but deploying tons of that manpower. Switzerland, not a beneficiary of the...
Ooh, that's a lot of money they're losing.
Yeah. Switzerland, not a beneficiary of the magnificent amounts of money, just capping 1,000 now, coming out of the Dutch merchant bank. So we will see if that continues to be the case. Of course, a certain amount of that is being sent towards Prussia right now. 750 ducats coming out of the Dutch, being funneled towards the signatories to that pact. You know that the Southern Europeans are hurting without that beautiful fiscal benefit that the Dutch and their allies are managing to capitalize on right now. What I want to know, Prussia, how militarized is Prussia? 100%, you love to see it. How about their absolutism? Also 100%, so they're getting the extra one discipline from that. This is quite the invasion force here from Prussia. It makes you wonder, what are they going to do? Do they have, they've no, you know, claims or anything to really capitalize on, but
we're still too early for imperialism, aren't we, in terms of taking great
sway now? Yeah, just two more techs before imperialism can kick in here, but we'll see. Just asking what's a good country to learn the game mechanics. The Ottomans are the correct answer to that question.
Portugal.
I will brook no disobedience. Yeah, Portugal also. Or Spain. Castile. Oh, God, you hear that noise? Look at this. Look at this.
Oh,
Switzerland is not going to go down easy. My goodness me. Okay. 46,000 ducats in the bank. We know they can't.
Is that just enormous amounts of loans?
Yeah. We could hear them coming in. It was purely tearing through a vast number of loans. I mean, he must be thinking about getting a couple of mercenary companies raising up. That isn't one, but I have to imagine we're going to see some mercenary companies pop soon to come to that. Is 46k all? What? All right, here we go. Bunch more chunking in. Got 200,000 men plowing in here, trying to get that woods bonus.
Oh, we didn't take it.
Didn't fall at the key moment. That would have been terrible. Look at this. 100,000 men not moving for the key stack, just moving past it, preventing the reinforcements, and maybe getting an opportunistic stack wipe on this 26k that Prussia isn't thinking to reinforce.
Well, but they're coming across the river.
They are. They did get the stack wipe there on 26,000.
If he attacks the reinforcing stack there, unless the Prussians just aren't going
have
to
it, yeah.
go for it.
Although it appears he's going down here. I mean, he's not going to win that fight, is he? Not in farmlands. 100k versus a good 160. He'd have to get quite a few more in. He doesn't have more unless he has mercenary companies waiting to pop.
And now the Swiss have got across the river.
What about Russia? I daren't look away, but I think Russia is pretty much 100% focused on Ming right now. Let's just take a quick look. Yep, they haven't moved in their extra troops just yet. Good Swiss rolls. That's making me hungry, chat. But pretty good rolls from the Swiss here. They did take a river crossing penalty, but they saved the fort, which gives them an opportunity to fight on that favorable terrain once again later on.
Yeah.
They don't have the numbers to support this one, though. I don't know. I'm not sure I would keep fighting as soon as it's clear that you're losing. I mean, look at these casualties. 3-1. 4-1 ratio, you know, they're losing Look at that. They're losing 4,000 men a tick to a mere 1,000 on the Prussian side. That's not a fight you want to be reinforcing. That's something you want to get out, come back. Because when they could pick their battles, they were doing okay when they were able to do that.
Yeah, I mean, I think at this point, once they've come in, they've taken that fort, they got a free stack wipe on a Prussian stack. Mm-hmm. You know, they've completed the objective there of just disrupting the Prussians' advance in that region. You don't need to then fight that battle to completion. You can just pull back.
Yeah. But the
main thing is they've now got to wait, you know, months and months and months again to try and take that fort.
Yeah.
Because the thing about that I always think with when you're attacking a nation is that if you are sieging forts in the bad terrain, like you are inherently vulnerable because you're pinned in one location.
Yeah.
And the enemy, if they engage you, has got an advantage.
Definitely the case. The manpower on the Prussian side has dropped by 100,000 since we were last looking. That was another opportunistic attempted stack wipe. This time they did withdraw before they'd taken just the maximal casualties. Even more infantry being plowed out here. Breslau also a woods, remember, so potential for something there. Manual wall breach, no doubt, right there on Fowls. And we can expect to see another attempt to relieve that siege, or perhaps the south. Another attempted wall breach, followed by an assault by the Prussians. Ooh. Not often seen. Tens of thousands of Prussians dying to get there, but they are going to take the fort in just another tick there. There it goes. Wow, that is that's quite something. Where's France? Play. France formed Switzerland again to go full circle. So there we go, another fort falls, and look at this, deployed offensively around the hill, the woods fort there, making sure they're going to secure this one to the rear. Wow, if Prussia is willing to spend the manpower to assault through forts, Switzerland needs to pull something out of the bag pretty fast, or they're just going to get beaten through. If they can crush through the rest of the forts, I don't know. Wow.
Well, I mean, super, super quickly it's turned around because, I mean, I don't know if it's partly because the Swiss had that stack routed rather than just retreating it and staying in the area. They're going to lose the fort in Fowls. And, I mean, there's a mountain or mountain forts or wooded forts? So
just wood forts, yeah.
Just wood forts. So it's still, you know, minus one.
I have just seen some back channel information, which I think will be of supreme importance to the chat. Breaking news out of India. Milan and the Pope, longtime allies, have decided that they are going to have a no-holds-barred 1v1 war in 1670 to decide the true master of Italy. Can you imagine the power of these forces combined? Place your bets now, chat. P in chat for a papal victory, M for an M for a Milanese victory. Who is going to win this one, Milan versus the Pope? I mean, Milan has been stronger so far. What are we looking at?
I think it's got to be Milan, hasn't it? They got a much better position. They can cut the Pope off from most of his empire.
They lack offensive, which leads them in a slightly weaker position on some things. But I really feel like the current manpower difference with the 500,000 almost manpower difference between them. And what about army size? What we got right now? We got 300 to 240. That can obviously change. They're all frantically drilling their armies, trying to get them in tip-top shape for the crucial battles that will come. We'll keep eyes on the Swiss even as we discuss this now, but that's going to be a fight that, honestly, they say it's a one-on-one war. Will their neighbors respect that? Well, will Serbia not want to heal the wounds of the past?
Fair, Serbia does have those provinces of Milan that are jutting out into them, which could do with being just corrected to get the nice borders.
What is this? I can't even say, but that state would be good if that could be tidied up.
So the poll is sort of 80% in favor of Milan at the moment, mm-hmm. One that's being done in chat.
You can vote in the poll as well as in chat itself. I do love to see the scrolling text of the votes, but obviously voting in the actual poll will be easier. Why is no one helping Switzerland? Well, I wasn't actually here, obviously, for the last 2 hours. I had to go and lose a coalition war of my own in my own EU4 game, but I don't really know what caused the breakup of this alliance, but it's obviously there's tension. Papal, Milan, Switzerland, something has caused this to fracture. What do we got here? Another mountain fort defense, but he hasn't got the men ready to put in there. They're going to get kicked out very soon. These guys are running not in a great direction for defense. I mean, that's something that the Prussians might well want to capitalize on.
You can see they're moving stacks already in that area.
We'll see. I mean, they're coming east. They're coming east. They're force marching. He's going for the stack wipe. He can't quite push though, because he can't get past these forts. So he's not going to be able to actually secure the complete victory. But chat reckons 80% in favor of Milan right now.
Yeah.
Which I have to say, that's about the odds I would probably give if I had to make a guess like that. But we'll see. We'll see. Hmm.
I think that Milan just if it is a 1v1 war, that Milan has a better position in that the Pope's armies are all in Italy at the moment.
Yeah.
In which case, the whole sort of western area of the Pope's empire, where there's forts to be sieged and walls to be gained, it's going to be quite hard for the Pope to defend it.
I don't think Milan's going to go over there. Let me switch to observer mode so we can talk about both without denying the chat the view of some of these fights up here. But I think the fight is going to be exclusively in this area. And yeah, part of it is just going to come down to who attacks.
We just smash into each other in one great clash of Italian nations.
I mean, there are... where are the Milanese forts? So, I mean, this whole area can be occupied before you get to a fort. And this is a farmland fort, which means the Pope can much more easily go on the offensive. But because they've got that thing they can siege without the without any problems of defensive penalties, since they can just rip into that farmland's fort. No problems to be had, but we'll see. Switzerland, honestly, fighting a very valiant, but I have to say it, doomed rearguard action. It would require major intervention to turn this war around. Potentially, they're trying to hold out long enough for Russia to do something. Russia is fairly easily dealing with Ming, which will eventually start to cut into their mandate. But, I mean, if I was Switzerland and I saw all these troops just hanging out here, I would not think much of my of the Russian attack, alleged attack. Oh, which, in fact, has actually ended, so ignore me. It's the Ming attack. I don't know why I was thinking Russia was in that war, sorry. It's a Ming intervention while Russia is at war with them. Right. Streamer blind, indeed. My bad. they are out. This is the capital siege now. Manual wall breach. You have to expect it at this point in the game. People have a lot of mill points going spare, especially people who have been got that Prussian government to give you that +2 on every single leader's monarch in.
So it looks like the Swiss now, having put up a pretty valiant fight, it's going to be hard for them now to come back from this, the capital being sieged. So I wonder what Prussia is going to be looking for in the peace deal here.
I don't know. I mean, remember, it's partly a Hanoverian attack.
Yes.
Yeah, it's technically a Hanoverian war.
Well, are there states that Hanover needs to complete in that area, or?
It doesn't look like it. No, that's Lower Rhineland. I don't think so, actually. I think they're pretty much divided along state lines, more or less right now, with the exception of just here for Prussia. But I suspect it's basically going to be a chunk and a chunk, perhaps clearing up some Austrian lands, Austrian and Bavarian lands.
Yeah.
We'll see. I suspect it's just going to be a fairly slow roll in rather than cutting all the way down or all that kind of stuff.
Oh, it's about Hanover. Apparently they said so in the in interviews. Fattening Hanover is the whole point of the war, says.
Right, okay, because Prussia feels like, as we were saying earlier, Hanover obviously pretty boxed in, Prussia having chance to expand east, consolidate a much larger territory. Hanover needs to cut down and get some extra land. Well, I mean, there's valiant fights here, so many mountain forts, but with the fall of the capital fort from Switzerland, you have to imagine they're going to be feeling the burn and getting a lot of war exhaustion from occupied home provinces, a lot of problems there. Oh, did manage to pull out a victory though there and stack wipe a Prussian army. You love to see the turnarounds. He might be able to capitalize on that and take this army out as well. We will see.
And just very quickly, I should bring chat up to date on, there's a new contest that has just gone live, which is a contest for the best historical post. So you should be able to see links in chat to where you can go to participate in the best historical post. So this is these are the posts that were on the Chronicle website. I can run through which ones they are whilst we sort of
Please do.
Interrupt me anytime, Michael, if there's anything very important to talk about. So the first one was the walls of the Bastion of the Caucasus, which was written by Georgia and details the great Caucasian wars that began in the year of our Lord 1637 when 1537. if I'm not mistaken, this is the war that we watched last night.
Look at this.
Where they attacked into Ajam and then the Ryazan ran undaunted into the heart of Georgia. This was an unwise move.
Very well phrased. Let me interrupt for a moment to just point out there are currently no active Prussian forces on the front line here. And it even looks like Prussia actually retreated incorrectly. Look at this. They might get another stack wipe. Prussia retreated one tile rather than back deeper into their lands.
Ouch.
A nine roll. It looks like they're not going to be able to get the stack wipe, though. Look at this, though. Look at the strength of these infantry divisions. They've got tons of them with one or two guys in them. Retreating again in the wrong direction.
Oh, they're going to stack wipes.
That's got to be a stack wipe. When are they arriving? Yeah, before the end of the month. Say goodbye to 30,000 Prussian souls. Wow. This is a really turn up for the books. I mean, Switzerland, I don't think they'll be able to survive after this, but we'll see.
So the next one, the competition was the recent victory to the McCarthy clan of Munster. It's written by the Irish guys, detailing their very initial victories when they unified Ireland. In 1441, the court of Munster decided to pursue a long-awaited goal of Irish unification.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
The clan McCarthy began by declaring war against the weak and corrupt clans ruling Cork and Tyrone. So, and then the Danish Terror, the third one. So, yeah, you can see chat and the links to vote. You can read all of these and decide which one you like the most. There's an assault going on against the
yet Prussian another fort. Assault. The poor fort of Breisgau needs some. I mean, I hate to be someone living in the area. They assaulted their way through 20,000 men and then retreated. That's got to hurt.
Ouch. That's an interesting approach.
We'll see if they're going to be able to hold here. They're retreating, not willing to take a fight with the hill with the woods disadvantage. That's interesting. But no peace offers have come in from Prussia yet. Nothing. No attempts to give like a 30 war score offer to stab it. Let's take a look from the Hanoverian perspective. What can they take? That's probably what I'd be looking at. What do you think, chat? What would you be looking for if you're Hanover in this war? If you're Hanover in this war, you're feeling pretty darn good, right? You're sitting here with no manpower, chilling out in friendly territory, while the Prussians get stack wiped, dying for you. I mean, it's pretty good. I'm being told Ming is falling, and my oh my, does that look to be the case? Look at this. Rajputana also cutting in from the south. Fantastic. Delivery of a hot drink. Thank you.
Yeah, Ming are in huge trouble.
Mm.
Their intervention doesn't appear to have worked out particularly well for them.
Well, they're certainly not able to actually get involved at all, but... we'll see. I mean, and obviously that devastation. Whoa, I think that might be the lowest. That might be the most negative mandate growth I have ever seen. Minus 7.6 a turn. Sorry, a turn, a month. It's going to be, it's not going to be long at all before they're completely fall apart. But that is crazy. Jerusalem is raiding our coasts. Does that mean you don't want our subsidies anymore?
I wonder how much they're making from that Jerusalem.
They must make a lot. I mean, has that caused... I'm not seeing any... I'm not seeing any raiding.
Maybe they're privateering in the node.
Maybe they were doing it in the New World somewhere. I'm not seeing... Do you think this is a lie? Malta, Cyprus, Cyprus, Malta. Ah, that's why. Well, it wasn't Cyprus. It was Malta. They loot Malta, and you're gonna say like we're gonna start something over that? That seems aggressive.
That's a heinous act of war.
They were obviously looting Sicily. Malta was collateral damage. That's not. I mean, come on. You can't. That's not a reason to start denying subsidies.
Yeah, it is unfortunate that they can't choose who to raid. It's just you raid the whole province's coast, or you raid none.
Meanwhile, in the Swiss War, the Swiss have been sent packing once again, and that looks to me like the death knell. I don't see them bringing this back now. Blood for Malta. Malta demands justice. Justice for Malta. Instant war declaration. Blood for the blood god. Look at that. I mean, Malta or war. I was saying it's not a big deal, but wars have started over less, so we might see a Dutch war.
The Malta,
Dutch...
as we know, the truly, you know, strategic island in the Mediterranean. Mm-hmm.
Malta had it coming. Remember Malta? That's good stuff.
I would very much love it if the Dutch decided to like to completely throw all of their entire country's economy and military into just destroying Jerusalem because they dared to touch Malta.
I'm being told there's some very interesting treaties being made on the Chronicles pack page. Josh, if you could possibly have a look at those while I keep our eyes on this these battles in the mountains. 21%, you know, 21% means it works every time. Oh, but not this time, which means they will be fighting at the negative two disadvantage as they move into Wallstadt. We'll see. Why die for Malta? Malta is Jerusalemian core land.
The only pact I'm seeing that wasn't there earlier is the Make Hanover Fat pact, which I'm assuming is what was enforced, wouldn't they, with this war on the Swiss.
One has to imagine, yeah. This looks like a battle that's not going to go well for the Swiss. However good the penalty, I mean, you can't win 60,000 to 220,000 when you've got the Prussians lined up against you. They're doing really well though, but no. As soon as those Swiss cannons end up on the front row, of course, they wisely retreated. Dutch are at war. They are. They're at war with Brunei right now. Just clearing up some of their colonies. Let's take a quick look at the Dutch colonial situation. They've tidied up pretty nicely over here. Got some fairly good situations. There's a pause. Was that a potential peace deal being sent? They are at 99% now in this war here, so I suspect that might be a peace deal pause. It was by Prussia. Yep, some land being handed over to Hanover now. All right, place your bets, chat. How much are they going to take? Are they going to sever the Swiss? That's, of course, the other, like, the power move by Hanover right here is just to carve them in half. I think they do have the war score, depending on where they draw the line. America, still pretty much as it was. We've got lots of Breton lands in the south, a lovely Irish Mexico, Norway dominating the east, except for a little Irish region here, Brittany on the west coast. Coming down here, we've got also Breton, New Zealand, Kilwin, Australia, and pretty much domination from Dutch Indochina. Ming continues to burn. India is pretty much united under the players. Georgia continues to have fantastic borders, and that is the world at seven.
Yeah.
Going back to Switzerland, I wonder what the...
Another peace deal coming in.
Another peace deal. Is it similar? It's different, actually, and it was accepted. It.
Okay, so there it is. So they've taken a more sort of nice contiguous block.
Mm, yeah, not taking cuts. Metz, notably not taking the fort of Metz.
Mm.
Only two forts in that peace deal. Interesting. Well, it's a very nice development in fusion for Hanover, that's no doubt. Do they have the admin to core it? They do. Pulling back now. Look, the Hanoverians actually moved in there right at the end, but we'll see. We'll see. Let's take a look at the Milanese development, because I've been being told it's even better than it was. My goodness.
We are less than a year before they begin their conflict, Milan and the Pope. So that's just a nice time for the Swiss to oblige in ending that war.
Yes, it certainly is. I mean, look at the development of some of these provinces. Oh!
Switzerland against Milan.
Swiss
and Greece.
Of Milanese heresy. Ooh. So there was a plan for the Milan to do the 1v1 with the Papal States. It looks like Switzerland did not care about this plan and has declared
They've jumped the... Unless, of course, that's secret and like other players don't know that. I'm surprised...
They accepted. The Pope accepted the call to arms. And they're charging straight in. The Pope... It looks like the Pope wasn't in on it because they're not at full strength. Wow, that changes everything. Going in, instant wall breach. They might be able to take this fort before either of them have any morale. Now that is a change. Oh yeah, 1v1, by the way. A 1v1, it will not be. The Swiss, the outside player. I mean, if you're the Pope and you've said, I won't attack with allies, but then your ally comes in afterwards. Hello.
Hello.
Hi, we can hear you now.
Yes. Now I'm in. I'm doing fine.
Okay, unlike Milan.
Right. We're going to discuss the alliance chart.
Yes, the current state of affairs, which, I mean, of course, the moment we come up, we bring you on to chat about it, everything blows up and the situation is going to start rapidly changing, but that's fine. We can still look at it. Milan, desperately trying to fight them off.
Because it is so much work to just keep everything updated.
I bet.
I am here at the Paradox headquarters at Stockholm, so I hear many of their colleagues want Netherlands to die.
it's a fairly popular belief or a desire, that is to say. At the moment, Milan is the one dying with the obviously the crushing in the unified Swiss and papal armies crushing through there. Talk to me a little bit about the Indian alliance and how they connect to the others. Where do their alliances lie outside of India?
The alliances from India. Mm. Yeah, they formed a bloc quite early with Georgia, which is still in their little alliance box over there. So it's Georgia, Deccan, Nepal, and Rajputana. And they are probably quite pleased with gobbling up Ming now, and people have started doing that. Isn't it so? I have my watch screen here.
They certainly have, yes.
Yeah. And then they will grow very large and might pose a threat to the established strong sides.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Because right now, the Netherlands-Prussia side is very strong.
Very strong indeed, yeah. For sure. For sure. Yeah. I feel like the... I mean, even with the wealth of Ming at their back, they're going to need to, there's going to need to be conversations with Jerusalem, with Andalusia. It would take a unified front to really pose a threat here. I mean, we're seeing Milan, one of the strongest opposers of Prussia, currently getting destroyed by Swiss soldiers that cut their teeth fighting Prussia. It's quite a sight to behold. Milan, who has obviously borne out, started so many wars and been so incredibly strong, being crushed back here. It's an F for Milan indeed.
Yes. But what I wonder is how long it will take before knives will start flashing when they grow afraid of one another and like afraid of Netherlands, afraid of their wealth and influence.
I don't know if they need to is the problem. They all have routes of expansion that aren't into the Netherlands.
Yeah.
So they've so well positioned themselves at the center of this web such that the knives can face outwards so easily. I mean, there's a lot of land to be taken in Switzerland, in Milan, in the Papal State, in Serbia, before anyone needs to turn on the Netherlands. And there's only so much left. I mean, what have we got left in the event? It's only another 3 hours.
Yeah, so Netherlands can expand freely and all of their minions can grow. And they are so small, so they're not a threat to, they have Prussia as their big beater, but Brittany, Hanover, and Norway are quite small in the grand
for sure
theme.
We've just seen unconditional surrender from Milan now towards the Swiss, land being handed to the Pope. So much for a 1v1 war. I'm sure we will hear harsh words from Milan about that at some later point. It's pretty incredible.
But I saw Milan stand there without allies for so long since all the wars started and people dragged them out of alliances and they were completely alone. Now, there have been several countries with just one ally sitting there, like putting all of their trust into one friend.
Yeah. Yep, certainly. And then that's obviously a hugely risky situation, which results in things like what you've just seen with Milan. They lost three fort provinces, two of which are in the mountains, which is going to make any comeback for them so incredibly difficult. It puts their capital, a farmlands, not on a fort province. That's truly devastating. They could at least potentially rebuild a fort here, and they've already got one here, so you can't actually move in here too easily. But I mean, that's pretty devastating. And the Pope, just taking a single province, Bino, I don't know, traditionally, of course, a papal vassal. So I don't know if that will be considered enough to say, yeah, sure. We can now we're gonna have our 1v1, right? It's 1670, time for the 1v1.
Or maybe we will see a kingdom of God before this ends.
We may. It's true. It's possible. It's possible. I mean, chat not moments ago was saying 80% chance of a Milanese victory in the 1v1. And then, of course, you know, the Pope probably, I have to imagine, knew that, knew those odds and decided that they were going to change things. They were going to sway things in their favor. But my, oh my, that is, that's a pretty crippling defeat. We're back to the no player war state of affairs. So we can take a, broader look here.
What will be the next war then?
Yeah, let's go,
Ireland.
They have long been denied their glorious revenge.